A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 4th April, on the front page you have RTI scrutiny will ruin judicial independence. So this is what the Attorney General says. He says collegium working must be confidential. So this is, you can see, the communication between center and the Supreme Court which happened. So it is activist Subhash Chandra Agarwal which has filed an RTI seeking the correspondence between Supreme Court, Collegium and the Centre on the appointment of Justices H.L. Dattu, A.K. Ganguly and R.M. Lodha, superseding Justices A.P. Shah, A.K. Patnaik and V.K. Gupta. So, this is being questioned, RTI is being demanded, but Supreme Court refuses and the case came before Central Information Commission which ruled in favour of Agarwal in 2009. And it dismissed the Supreme Court's argument that judiciary should be free from intrusions by strangers. So, Supreme Court appeals in Delhi High Court against the Central Information Commission verdict. And the High Court dismissed the appeal. In January 2010, you can see, again, 3-judge High Court bench upheld the High Court decision of dismissing the appeal. Then, in November 2010, Supreme Court appealed to itself. And the Supreme Court bench referred the appeal to a 3-judge bench. 3-judge bench in August 2016 referred the appeal to a constitution bench. So you can see it has been going on since the CIC ruled in favor of Agarwal in 2009. So since then it has been 2019 now. A decade passed since CIC upheld the order, but the Supreme Court has been appealing. And finally now the constitution bench is going to hear the matter. And if constitution bench now in 2019 upholds the CIC Central Information Commission order of 2009, then ordinary citizens would be empowered to seek confidential details of all judicial appointments and transfers, which will open a Pandora's box, judiciary Pandora's box. There will be many secrets which would come out. Then next is SkyMet expects a below normal monsoon. So this is the private weather forecasting agency SkyMet. So it has now said that earlier it had said last month that there would be no doubt, no drought, and now it says that there will be below normal monsoons. So this is the prediction which it has put forth. So Indian Meteorological Department IMD is the official, you know, government weather forecasting agency, and SkyMet is a private weather forecasting agency. Then this is JNK government bars civilian traffic twice a week on national highway. So the Jammu and Kashmir government has decided to bar civilian traffic on the 270 km long Baramulla Srinagar Udhampur national highway twice a week to facilitate the movement of vehicles of security forces. So the Pulwama attack we saw left 40 CRPF jawans dead. So now this is being done, that traffic for civilians would be barred when twice a week. On page 5 you have sudden release of water from dams worsened Kerala floods. So this is the amicus curiae, means friend to the court, who says that those in charge shouldn't have relied only on Indian Meteorological Department predictions. So this is regarding the Kerala floods which happened last year. So this is also going on because it is also alleged here, as you can see, that sudden release of water from dams worsened the floods. Then on page 6 you have minors, Meghalaya to move Supreme Court for end to operation. So the court had actually asked centre and Meghalaya government to continue efforts to retrieve bodies. So this is regarding the Meghalaya minors who had been trapped in the rat hole mine which was prominently in news some time back. So this has been going on for so long, it has been actually months now. So now the Meghalaya will move Supreme Court to end the operation. On page 7 you have group chats, WhatsApp users get more control. So this is now users can decide who can add them. So this is what has been decided on, and this is the steps which WhatsApp has taken. So measures which have been introduced by WhatsApp to curb fake news. And this is BSNL gets license for Wi-Fi on flights. So we had seen how the government had approved the policy for having Wi-Fi on flights. So, state-owned telecom company, that is BSNL, has been given the license by the Department of Telecommunication to provide internet and mobile services on flights. And below you have air pollution shortened lifespan by 30 months. So this is a study which claims poor air quality caused 1.2 million deaths each in India and China in 2017. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Words and Deeds. So this is regarding the campaign. So it says the Congress must discuss the roadmap for implementation of its manifesto. So this is an editorial on Congress manifesto, which was front page news yesterday. And this is Serious Setback. So this is regarding the Supreme Court ruling quashing the February 12th circular of RBI. So this could undo credit discipline in the banking system is what is being feared. So this was also front page news yesterday, the editorial on that. The lead article, a very risky gamble in Wayanad. So this is completely political. Rahul Gandhi standing in for elections of a second seat in Wayanad in Kerala. And this is proving a point on audit trail. So this is regarding EVMs and VVPAT debate. So it says Nizamabad has 185 candidates. It is an opportunity for the election commission to settle the EVM and VVPAT debate. So this is Nizamabad parliamentary constituency in Telangana. Here the number of candidates standing for elections is 185 and the EVMs can cater to only 63 candidates and nota. So election commission is now considering special machines which can accommodate up to 384 candidates. So these will use 24 ballot units connected in series. So this is regarding this aspect and how this VVPAT issue can also be put into use here too, and this debate can be put to a halt because ballots which were used earlier took a lot of time. It took 40 hours to declare results with ballot papers, and with EVMs it is only 4 hours. So the benefits of EVMs over ballot papers is of course there. Then on op-ed page you have turf issues in fighting corruption. So there are other bodies also apart from Lokpal which fight corruption, like Central Vigilance Commission, the CBI. So this article says how the Lokpal, CVC and CBI coordinate will be crucial. On international page you have Bouteflika resigns but calls for sweeping change continues. So this is regarding Algeria, the northern African country. So here Bouteflika, the president, has been, there were protests going on for him to resign, and now he has finally resigned. And but the protests are continuing because what they demand is sweeping change in the country's political system. So this has been in news for long. So now this long reign comes to an end. Then this is US State Department approves $2.6 billion chopper sale to India. So this is regarding the sale of 24 MH-60R Romeo multi-mission helicopters to India. So this will be under the Foreign Military Sales Program. On business page you have why a rate cut won't help lower lending rates. So this is regarding how linking of floating lending rates to an external benchmark is not operational yet. Though retail inflation, which is the central bank's RBI's main yardstick for policy making, has rose to a 4-month high of 2.57% in February, it is still below RBI's medium term target of 4%. So that is why it is said rate cut won't help. Then on the last page you have South Korea first to roll out 5G services, beating US and China. So 5G technology will be first launched in South Korea on Friday, that is 5th April 2019. So it rolls out the latest wireless technology, 5G technology, which is expected to change the landscape of the gaming industry. So it will be through Samsung Electronics 5G enabled smartphone Galaxy S10 that 5G technology would be available. And this is bleaching hits world's southernmost coral reef. So this is bleaching which has taken place here in the southernmost coral reef of the world, that is the Great Barrier Reef. So Great Barrier Reef is to the north of Australia, and this is here coral reefs of Lord Howe Island, which is some 600 km off the shore from Sydney down. So they were not affected by the bleaching which damaged Great Barrier Reef in 2016 and 17, but this time they have been hit. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asia.com and avail the current affairs PDFs too, plus also current affairs videos, full videos are also available. Thank you.